Now we have another development in a continuing KCRA 3 investigation on California's realignment program. It's a program that critics say have put thousands of dangerous parolees onto our streets.
And if and when captured, they often spend just days in the county jail. As Mike Lurie has been covering this, this story and this example has just torn a Stockton family apart.
And this case shows just how much the rules have really changed under realignment, because parolees can now avoid state prison for violating parole. And in this case, a young woman is in a wheelchair after a beating, and the man accused of trying to kill her was a parolee, a felon, whom the family says should have remained behind bars.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Brandy Areola is 21 years old, and she can barely count to 20. She was brutally beaten and left for dead. Brandy spent 6 months in the hospital, most of it in a coma.
They wanted me to pull the plug after 2 weeks. I said, no, God's going to bring her back. God's going to bring her back. He makes miracles, and he did.
Brandy Areola is alive and in a wheelchair now, with the mental capacity of a child just beginning to learn her colors.
What color is this shirt?
Black.
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 We're getting it.
Donna Munoz is angry because she says the system failed her, a system that allowed a parolee named Raul Leyva to roam free after his release from prison. Records obtained by KCRA 3 show Leyva had previously served prison time for assault, vehicle theft, and drug use. After his release, he was supposed to register as a sex offender and wear a GPS tracking device. Authorities say he failed to do so and rearrested him last March. But instead of returning to state prison, under California's realignment plan, he was sent to the San Joaquin County Jail and then released in just 18 days, according to records obtained by KCRA 3. Days later, Randy Areola was severely beaten, and the man accused of the crime was her boyfriend, Raul Leyva, who is now back in the San Joaquin County Jail, facing 6 felony counts, including attempted murder.
Why is he still walking? Why is he still walking? This wouldn't happen to my daughter today if they would have kept him behind bars.
Raul Leyva pled not guilty to those felony charges in June. His next court appearance is coming up on November 26th.
So this is just an example of realignment in what parolees can do. So what are authorities saying about this particular case with this man?
Well, they're very concerned about it. And coming up tonight at 11, we'll hear from one of those parole agents on this case, an agent who was told not to talk to us. But tonight, that agent speaks out for the first time and blames the system for what happened here. We'll hear from her coming up tonight at 11.
Great job. You're uncovering so many things, so many layers of this case.